Welcome into Outkick the Show, Beach Edition. I got kids building sandcastles, fighting directly to my right. So if chaos erupts, it could at any moment. Beautiful beach day down here. 2 weeks now on the beach. Fantastic time in Florida. Thanks to Governor Ron DeSantis for opening up the state. We got a lot to get to here. Thanks to my wife, by the way, who is holding the camera here and recording as we get ready to go get some ice cream with the kids. And they're excited to already go. Several different things. Sunday and Monday, spectacular numbers on coronavirus. The number of cases declining rapidly. I keep telling you that the significant thing is the percentage of the cases that are positive, not the number of positive cases. We are headed now for the best Tuesday since March. Tuesday, a lot of times, is a catch-up that takes place where suddenly the numbers are going to blip up, but the numbers are not going to be anywhere near as bad as they have been
that's not even our kid.
That's kidding. That's my youngest deciding to dance behind me. Several different additional storylines. So that's the coronavirus update. L.A. County report from the L.A. Times that they're not going to open till the end of July, which is absolute insanity. Here's what I've learned in general about reopening. You can't reopen parts of states for very long without people losing their mind. The city of Nashville is a good example. If you drove like 10 minutes outside the city of Nashville, restaurants, gyms, haircuts, salons, all of it was open. And Nashville, which is in Davidson County, wasn't open. And people rightfully said, this is ludicrous. So if LA County tries not to open while the state of California is opening, people are going to drive outside of L.A. County, and they're going to be furious over everything. Some of you must be funny because my wife is laughing. Something funny in the comments?
Your sunglasses are crooked.
Probably because they've been broken.
They
by
are the, broken. It's
broken
true.
By the kids having to carry them around. All right. As if that were not enough. Let me talk.
Okay. Nash, sit down. Sit down. Keep digging the hole.
Let me talk about MLB for a minute. Here's the deal. Major League Baseball has to come back, and Major League Baseball has to come back because the owners have given the players a good offer, 50-50 on revenue. They don't know how much revenue they have in an 82-game regular season that would start sometime around July 4th, be a designated hitter. They would play at home. They would expand the playoffs. All of this makes complete sense. The players have to make a decision about whether they're going to maintain a good decision for fans or whether they're going to be idiots about not coming back, aka what happened back in 1994. If you remember back in 1994, they called off the season. I was 15 years old then. I walked away from baseball. I was a huge fan at the time. Watched the Cubs on WGN all the time. Watched the Braves all the time on WTBS. Grew up a Cincinnati Reds fan. And when they did, but if they don't, then baseball players shouldn't get paid a dollar this year. Because if they turn down the opportunity to work, they shouldn't get a dollar. And that's the way that the solution should be set out. The owners have presented a good option. The players are somehow concerned about the idea of a salary cap. This is not a difficult structure. Nobody knows how much revenue is going to be produced by a shortened season, potentially without fans. So why not go ahead and make the smart decision, agree to take half of the revenue for this year. These are unique times. Come back, serve your fans, treat them with respect, and be there for them, all right? Now, on the NBA front, the NBA needs to get back. This is ludicrous. The NBA is now polling its players like they're doing the old school yes, no, or maybe when you used to be trying to find out whether a girl or boy liked you in elementary school. They are sending messages out there and asking the NBA players, do you want to come back or not? Yes or no? And so as a result, I think the call is easy. The NBA should be back. And look, if the NBA players don't come back, everybody should be refunded for their cable and satellite costs. Every single dollar should be paid back if they don't want to come back. Because why should you and I be paying for their salaries on television when they aren't fulfilling their contractual obligations? MLS is talking about coming back now at Orlando down at the Disney World, Wide World of Sports. This makes a lot of sense to me. My wife tells me they have like 15 or 16 soccer fields there. They can easily play for as long as they needed to until they can go back to their home stadiums. I think that is a very logical decision. I think it's a smart one. Props to MLS for being proactive and trying to get it done. Let me say this. If you're a player and you don't want to come back, you don't have to. Nobody has to go back to work. If you're afraid of the virus, if you're afraid of the obligations that come with playing, there are tons of people in the MLS, in MLB, and in the NBA that would love to have those jobs, that would kill for them. And so as a result, let them have those opportunities. This is a no-brainer. Come here. Come here. You want to get on so much instead of running around behind your dad. Did I hit every subject that I told you I wanted to hit? I think I did. Look,
did you talk about basketball?
Is coming back. Yeah, that's the NBA. College football
I know,
is coming. College
sorry,
football
I was paying attention
is coming
to the
back.
Kids.
And everybody out there who's arguing otherwise is wasting their time arguing about it. We're going to have college football. It's going to be back this fall. I think there's even a chance that we're going to have fans back in the stadiums in a decent way. If you look at the coronavirus numbers, everything is trending in a good direction. Don't buy into the doom and gloom. We're going to be fine. All right, I think that's all. We got to go get ice cream. This is Clay Travis, Outkick the Show, live from the beach. Appreciate all of you. Share the show if you liked it. I'll see you guys tomorrow.